احمد صلی اللہ رسول الکریم اما بعد فاعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم بسم الرحمن الرحیم رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی. I welcome you all on this lecture on self-discovery. So before we begin with the purpose of life, let's analyze this world, the world in 21st century. So what is the world in 21st century? If you analyze around, we have progressed a lot into material welfare, right? So we have the best buildings that were ever made in the history of mankind. We are blessed with the best gadgets. Such gadgets weren't there with the people that were living before. Now we have the best energy resource that could have been ever found in the humanity of this world. And according to Professor Hootboy, which I recently read his status, that space ship has been sent in the air, right? So we are in that point of life where humans have traveled to the Mars or the moon, right? They have traveled to the moon. But the sad thing is that we haven't really learned to live on Earth. So like, I'm a teacher and I know that when we have all the progress, when we have everything, all the material facilities and everything, the society is going morally bankrupt. We are living in the same society where rapes are being done every day, where recently even children are being raped. This is the society we're living in, where people are taking drugs. A lot of people are taking drugs, where people are actually fighting one another over the wealth. This is the modern day society. And the modern day society which we live in, on one side it has progressed, it has become one of the greatest society. But on the other side, what we are seeing is a vacuum. There's a vacuum, and there's a vacuum inside the people themselves. We see that a lot of people are committing suicide. Children who are very young in age are committing suicide. So the first thing that I want to ask you is a rhetorical question, but I want the answer for that. How many of you know your students or someone in your class or your relatives or cousins who are on drugs? Do you don't know anyone who's on drugs? No. Is shisha a drug or not?
No.
Shisha is not a drug. According to what?
Nicotine.
Nicotine. Fine. Then what is a drug? What is the definition of drug?
Anything which takes you high out of your senses.
Okay. And anything that is addictive?
Yeah.
Right. Drug too. In Islam, the concept of drug is that anything that intoxicates in a larger quantity is not allowed, even if it doesn't intoxicate at that particular point. Right. So recently, my student, I'm a teacher, so I interact with a lot of students. My student from a very elite school, which obviously I wouldn't want to name, but one of the elite school in defense started taking drug. And the first drug which he took was hash. What is a hash? Any idea what a chars? Okay. So a student of a particular school who is in O levels is taking hash, right? And then there are multiple more drugs that he started taking. What is the reason for that? Why is he taking hash?
Depression.
Not depression.
Enjoyment.
Enjoyment. Luxury. You know, I want to become someone who is acceptable to society. A lot of peer pressure. So when I digged in his story, what happened was two of his friends offered him some cigarette. And then, you know, if I am not going to take cigarette, I am going to be considered alienated. I am going to consider outdated. So the problem with us humans living in defense, particularly the elite, are not the problems that people face because of poverty. Our problems are different than those people who don't have anything to eat. Our problem is excess of money. Okay, so we people have a lot of money that we don't understand what should we do with it. Our problem is making an identity, you know, being popular in the circle of O levels and A levels. The definition of courage has become someone, a girl who is sitting with four boys and laughing with them. This is the definition of courage according to us. This is empowerment according to us. Although she might be a U grader, right? She might be getting 3 C's in her O levels result, but a girl who can speak good English, who knows how to dress well, who has a lot of money, who is traveling on V8 or Audi, She might be a loser in her life. She might be very arrogant with her parents, but she is considered someone very cool. Of coolness for our side. This is the symbol of coolness which is accepted in the society. So the definition of coolness for us is a guy. He doesn't even know how to earn money, but because his father is a bureaucrat, his father is a politician, his father has gifted him some certain cars, and his father has a Vigo Dalla. You know, a police protocol Vigo Dalla, which is being with him 24/7. He is considered the icon of the society. This is the 21st century. And the way our society is going, it's moving so fast that yesterday, some years before, homosexuality, gays and lesbians was considered an immoral act. In America, a person who was homosexual was asked to go to a doctor for his treatment. But just after, within 50 to 60 years later, it has become legalized. America has accepted homosexuality as a third gender. According to Dr. Bilal Phillips, he says that different forks for different strokes, right? So this is the definition. We say that, okay, if someone is a male, he wants to marry a female, no problem. Someone is a male, wants to marry a male, no problem. And in some of the books in Britain that are being transferred, they have started writing a story. John was one of a person and his parents were looking for some girls, but he didn't really like girls. So now he liked one guy and now they gave the permission for John to marry. So this is what we are being done. So if you consider the society right now, corruption at its peak, immorality at its peak, and no matter, a day is going to come when incest is going to be legalized as well. Incest means marrying your own sister, marrying your own mother. They're going to say the same. You know, what's the harm if a person wants to marry his mother? A day is very close. So if you think about the society, the way society is going, the way society is advancing, it's going very fast on a directionless way. So our society is going very fast in no direction. Just like a bus. 21st century is a bus. And you all are sitting, I'm sitting in the same bus. And the bus is going on a very high speed. And now, suppose the brakes of the bus has failed. There are no brakes of the bus. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? What's the common answer? If there's a bus you are sitting in and the brakes have failed, what are you going to do? Imagine this world universe, this world that we live in, is the same bus that is going on a very high speed without brakes. There's no end to anything right now. Is there any end to anything? But we don't have time. We don't have time to think. Why don't we have time to think? Because we are engrossed, we are being programmed by facilities, by the TV, by social media website. Someone is going to say kalima, someone is going to jump out of the bus. But is there any other possibility? Is there any other possibility than these two possibilities? Someone who is very intelligent, who is very wicked, is going to go and sit on the driver's seat. And recently on motorway, there was a driverless container that was going. And someone, what he did? He tried to stop. And how did he stop? What he did was that he tried to produce the friction as much as he could. So there was a road barrier and the container. And he was dealing with the container in a way that the container doesn't go on the other side of the road, but also at the same time keeps on hitting the barrier. So the maximum friction that is being produced is going to do that. And you all have the similar role. If the world is changing, then why are you not stopping the change? Can't you stop the change? If someone is doing evil thing, can't you just stop the change? But now rather the world has made us realize that the change will come, and it will come with a very good label. Like Valentine's Day, 14th of February. But if you break down the word, take all the labels away, what is the Valentine Day? It's a day of adultery. And according to some hardcore scholars, whom I respect a lot, what they say is when someone says, will you be my Valentine? He's saying that I want to become a Zani. Will you be my Zaniya? That's all. Isn't it so? What you're saying is that I want to do something wrong with you. I want to commit adultery with you. Will you be my partner in it? And this is the concept of Valentine Day. And there are similar more days like that. So we don't really think. We have never thought about the existence of our life because of the social media, Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, because of the parties that are being arranged at our different homes, different friends, because of the education. What we think is that it's enough for us to do O-levels, to do A-levels, and then to go in any Ivy League university. Let it be MIT or any other university. Our worth is going to get determined by the labels that we are going to get. The educational labels that we are going to get. Oh, that person is a graduate from LUMS. One of the luckiest person ever. Gone to LUMS. Isn't it? I'm not saying that that is bad. So don't try to misunderstand me. I'm not saying that that is bad. What I'm saying is that should it be the only criteria? Should it be the only criteria? No. People think that when they are going to take alcohol, when they are going to take drugs, it's going to solve their problems. But someone once said that alcohol is not the solution. It even kills your question. So alcohol is not the solution. It even kills your question. The depression of your life, you take alcohol, gone. Because you're sleeping, you don't even know what was the question in the first place. We're going to take a short break. Inshallah, we're going to resume after Maghrib. Jazakallah. I welcome you all with the second session. Before break, we discussed that alcohol is not the solution, but it also kills your problem, right? We also discussed that a poor person's problem is food. But a rich person's problem is Tony who died recently. So that are the two different problems. And we need to address all these problems according to the environment they live in. So we have a different set of problems which other people have in the other part of the world. And then we also discussed that we have reached the lowest level of morality despite the advancement of technology. So we have reached that level of morality where people are killing one another and they are doing all sort of evil act. Now we discussed about the bus. The world is a bus and we are getting over there and there are no brakes to it. Fine. Now we'll discuss that our ambitions. If I ask you to label one by one, what do you want to become? Do you like slavery? Is there anyone who likes slavery? Is there anyone who wants to become a slave of anyone? No. Okay, we are going to discuss this later. Okay, so mark these questions. We are going to address it. And unless or until you don't get the answer, you're not going home. Right? So you have to get the answer before leaving this place. Now all of us think that if we are going to get whatever we desire of, if we are going to get all straight A's, if we are going to get admission in a good university, if we are going to get V8, okay, we are going to be one of the most happiest person ever. Is it true? No. Who says, so one of the famous actor by the name of Jim Carrey, how many of you have heard him? One of the actor who has worked in The Mask, in the movie The Mask. He says that if people were given the wealth and the fame and everything that they desired of, then they realized that this is not the solution. So whatever you realize of, that is not the solution for your problem. And Ibn Taymiyyah, he says the similar thing. Ibn Taymiyyah is a classical scholar. What he says is that you might think that you know yourself, but If you feel hungry, if you eat something because of you feel hungry, or if you fight with someone because you're angry, you are no different than an animal. Because animals also do the same things. So Ibn Taymiyyah says, then what makes you different is who you really are. And that brings the topic to the big questions that we never thought of. Before asking those questions, imagine that you are asleep and then you get awake at Emirates, the best airline ever, in a business class. And you know, people are serving you best comfortable cushion. Everything is so best. You're going to call the air hostess. You're going to say that how the hell did I get over here? Because when you just woke up, you were over there. Will it make you happy or satisfying that you have all the comfort? You're probably one person of the people on the mankind who have traveled on Emirates. Will it make you happy? Or is it going to ask some questions in your mind that how did I get over here? Where am I? Where am I going? And what's going to happen? These are all the questions that your mind is going to ask you. Will you find peace just by saying that no, let me enjoy this Emirates. I don't know whether I'm going to get over here again or not. No, there's not going to be any peace. Why do we forget these questions when we are living? Why is it so that we have forgotten about these questions? Similar to a person who just opens his eyes and he finds himself in a factory. A lot of people are working over there. Let him be a Jew, a Christian, a Buddhist, a Hindu. All these questions are the natural questions that are going to come in his mind. How did I get into this world? Where am I going? What will happen to life after death? Ibn Taymiyyah says that unless or until you ask yourself these questions, you are not going to find the true meaning of life and the true meaning of happiness. But we don't ask these questions to ourselves. How many of you have ever asked this question to myself? And what am I doing over here? We don't ask any questions. When you're going to ask these questions, your mind will be obliged for you to think on it. So your mind will ask you that what are the answers of these questions? And the answer of these questions is one set of question. This is one set of question. This is the theory of existence. And some of the philosophers also say that the human beings are drowned into this world. This is the theory of existence. What we fail to realize is that this slider has a purpose. The computer, this classroom has a purpose. Then why is it that human beings who are more complex than the chair, the projector, the computer doesn't have any purpose? We don't think about that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defines the purpose of our life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we have created these people. Do they think that they are there for nothing, without any purpose, and they will soon return to me? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Mu'minun, in verse number 115, that we are certainly here for a purpose, and that is a greater purpose. Now, one is purpose as an individual. We have a purpose as an individual, but one is as a purpose of an ummah, of a society. And what is that purpose? What is the purpose of that society that we are living in as Muslims? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that. Allah says that وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا, that verily we have made this ummah as ummatan wasata, as the middle ummah, so that you bear witness against or on the mankind, and the Messenger of Allah bear a witness on you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah that the purpose of this ummah is a middle ummah. You are like those people who when start worshipping, worship 24/7, neglect our family, who go to jungles and then try to find God. We are not like those people. Neither are we those people who don't pray at all. But rather we are amongst those people who interact with mankind and who also meditate in privacy. One of the companions said that I'm not going to sleep with my wife ever in life. The second one said that I'm going to do the fasting because they lost the true concept of being Ummat-e-Wasat. And the Messenger of Allah later explained them that no, I fast and there are certain days I do not fast. I sleep at night and there's a certain portion of night that I pray. Subhanallah, this is the middle ummah. This is the middle ummah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defines our purpose in Surah Ali Imran, verse number 110. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat lin nas. That you are the ummah for the mankind. Tamuruna bil ma'rufi wa tanhauna anil munkar. That use ask people to do good and you stop them from evil. But subhanallah, where have we placed ourselves? Where have we placed our position in this dunya? Not only have we forgotten our individual existence, we have also forgotten the role of this ummah in the society. So the same ummah that is being called as the best ummah, that is being called as ummatan wasata, the just ummah or the middle class ummah, the ummah on the middle, the same ummah is now celebrating weddings according to Hindus. So our celebration of weddings is like Hindus. But the only thing that we have kept Quran for is to get barakah out of it. You know, the bride, no matter she has ever heard about anything, when she comes, she has to go through Quran. Okay, the Quran is going to be on the top of her head. What is the purpose of that? Okay, this is a source of barakah. And if you really think that this is the source of barakah, then why are you playing the music? On the other hand, Asad, did you choose your name? No. Did you choose your parents? No. Did you choose your ethnicity? Did you choose to be Punjabi? No. Okay. Did you choose your DNA? No. Then what did you choose? Is there anything that you made a choice of? No. What's your name?
Ahmad.
Ahmad?
Yeah.
Ahmad, did you choose your name?
No.
No. Your parents?
No.
Your siblings?
No.
Where do you live?
Gulberg.
Did you choose that you are going to be one of Pakistanis?
No.
No. So you didn't choose anything. All of us didn't choose a single thing. What does it mean? Then why do you say that I'm liberated? I'm a very free person. As a humans, do we have choice?
Yes.
What is the choice?
Choose between good and bad.
Okay. The second aspect of this is, what I'm trying to say is, that you all are, you have a partial choice, but you all are full slaves. Okay, if someone says that, you know, I'm not a slave of anything, let me be who I am. And the logo of Sprite, Man Ki Maan. So if someone is going to see this logo on a billboard, and he's a killer, he's going to say, Man Ki Maan, let me go and kill someone. A daku is going to motivate him. Okay, today I have robbed 6 people, tomorrow I'm going to rob 20 people. Man Ki Maan. This is what we have been programmed according to the society that we live in. And Allah on the other side says that who is the one who has taken his desires as God? Well, some people have taken their desires as God. So the topic we are discussing right now is that we do have a purpose, but on the other hand, we are not free as we think we are. There are two options. Either you accept yourself as a slave of Allah. Now this is going to be an intellectual argument. It's okay if you want to refute me, I'm prepared for that. Okay, so if you don't really agree with me, then let's have a a dialogue, okay, not a debate, but a dialogue, okay, to just clear things up. So either we have a choice to become a slave of Allah, or we have a choice to become a slave of society. Is there any other choice? So if we break it down, we have a choice to be a slave of our Creator, or we have a choice to be slave of society. So if someone argues that, you know, no, I have a choice to be whatever I want to do, I can do. I have a choice of this. I have a choice to be whatever I am. You don't really have a choice. Let me tell you how. Because whatever you see, whatever you're being programmed with, actually makes your choices. So what clothes do you like? Do you like formal or do you like informal? Are being programmed in your mind. You really don't have a choice. Now tell me from your personal experience that how many of you have a haircut because this is in fashion? Or you have ever thought of? So most of us, we can't have a choice in our haircut. You might not like spikes, but some tennis player, some football player is going to wear it. We want to adopt whatever people think is acceptable and whatever people think is not acceptable. But Islam, on the other hand, condemns you. You know, one of the maqasid of Sharia is that it wants to safeguard your intellect. So that is why intoxication and other things are not allowed in Islam. But we are being influenced by the media, by the social media, by the peer pressure. We don't want to get alienated. We want people to accept us. This is the reason why we adopt certain things and why we want to dress in a certain way. Ibn Qayyim says that the true happiness is being found when you enslave yourself from the enslavement of society to the enslavement of one Creator. Because once you enslave yourself to only one Creator, it's going to solve all of your problems. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Zumar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks an intellectual question, that is the person who has multiple masters better, or the person who has only one master? Who is better?
One master.
But we have, subhanallah, multiple masters. Master of wealth. So this money, this piece of note is saying that I am the one who controls your life. Isn't it so? What is the worth of this? But this is actually saying you, to each one of you, even to me. I'm not saying don't earn money. But this is saying that I am the one who controls your life. I am the one because of which you don't talk to your siblings. I am the one because of which your father doesn't talk to your chachu. I am the one. I am the one because of which you work so hard that in the end you have to end up in ICU. Okay? Done a lot of corruption that when it gets caught, heart failure. Medicines, thank you for this. So we are enslaved to money. We are enslaved to people, to our circumstances. We are enslaved to the media. Whatever media asks you to do, you do it. And subhanallah, there are some people, they start on copying others so much, to such an extent, that they don't really understand. It seems like that person has become a carbon copy of this person. A multiple Shah Rukh Khan and Salman Khans found in Pakistan. Do you think just by wearing those clothes, that kind of a hairstyle, is going to become a very good actor? With such things, a lot of people shifting to Q-Mobile. You guys don't shift. But a lot of lower class, middle class, working class shifts because so and so actor has come in the commercial of that. Being a brand ambassador. You know, you need to realize your worth. And unless or until you don't realize your worth, you're going to stay the same. So the solution is, if you want to discover yourself, plug yourself out of social media apps. Okay? Because you're being programmed in a certain way. Mr. Mark is a very intelligent person. You know the algorithms of your app, they identify each of the algorithms which the pattern of your thinking is, and the newsfeed comes accordingly. So if you are a jihadi, most likely the newsfeed is going to be full of such posts. And according to one research, this mind has a certain ability to take decisions. Our mind has certain ability to take decisions. And that ability is exercised, exhausted because of the social media website. Now, what is that ability? For instance, your mind has a certain ability to take some decisions of life. On social media website, it tests your decision making, okay? Way to comment, way not to comment. Whom to add and whom not to add. Get yourself out of the peer pressure. It's going to end you in drugs. And according to one of the survey in the Dawn News, almost 8 million people, Pakistani people, are drug addicts. Get yourself out of it. Get yourself out of this MK, Zara, these brands. I know that makes you feel good. But if you're feeling so cold and you're just wearing a certain dress because it makes you feel good, it makes people appreciate you on a wedding, then actually you are harming yourself. A lot of our time goes into what should I wear that day. The cultural invasion that we are living in, we need to get out of it. And the only way to get out of it is enslaving yourself to only one and only creator. Just enslave yourself to one and only creator. And realize that you all are valuable. You all have your strengths and your weaknesses. We all are blessed with a box of treasure that is just near us. But rather than finding our own strengths and weaknesses, we try to get the treasure out of someone's box. If someone is pretty, why am I not pretty? I think I need to change my nose. And the last advice from me is engage yourself in finding the true meaning of life. Right? Exhaust yourself in those activities that is going to bring productivity in your life rather than those activities that is not going to bring anything in your life. You like cooking? Fine. Get enrolled in a cooking class. You like horse riding? Get enrolled in a horse riding class. You like public speaking? Get enrolled in different debates. But someone, I don't want to get enrolled in anywhere. My father is very rich. He's going to sponsor me. Let me take some drugs. Go on a party. You're wasting your time. You're wasting the energy that Allah has given you. Allah has given all us the abilities to make a change. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Hashr, do not be like those people who forgot Allah. And so Allah made them forget themselves. Do not be like those people who have forgotten themselves. And try to realize that we have two aspects of our life. You know, our body consists of a ruh and of a body. So sometimes we cultivate our body so much that we oppress the ruh. We don't really think about it. Think about the spiritual aspect of life. Don't just think about the material, metaphysical aspect of life. Do not be like those people who go after the desires and the doubts. Do not be like those people. That was the end of it. Wa akhru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.